submission, please stand for prayer.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Jesus, you were educated by the example of Mary, Saint Joseph, and the community of people around you. You observed behaviors and actions that helped to form you for your ministry. Help us grow in wisdom as we learn from our teachers, parents, and coaches. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Boo.
Thursday Mass. Come join us in the chapel today at lunch with Father Jim. A request from Mr. Grant. If you have or seen his orange phone charging block, please return it to him.
Seniors, remember that tomorrow is the senior breakfast. Please meet in the cafe at 8 a.m. This is a required school day for you. Details about the day were sent to you at your Mission Prep email account. See you all tomorrow.
Spring sports pictures have arrived. Stop by Mr. Eklund's to pick them up.
Battle of the Bands. Participants, Friday, May 17th, gym sophomore band will be meeting at lunch. Freshman, junior, senior, and teacher bands are meeting after school at 3:15. Monday, May 20th, gym soundcheck at 3:15.
Prom. Once upon a prom this Saturday, May 18th at Tooth & Nail Winery in Paso Robles from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Juniors and seniors, a link has been sent to you to vote for prom king and queen. Polls close today.
Seniors, checklist. Seniors, gather your signatures for your senior checklist and turn it in to the registration office to receive your diploma.
Service opportunities. Thursday, May 16th, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Need students to help set up the stage for Battle of the Bands. Wednesday, May 22nd, we need help in watching the children of your beloved teachers while they attend the year-end dinner. Pizza will be provided. This is a super easy and fun way to knock out a bunch of service hours. Sign up at Ms. Beckett's office in room 313.
AP exams, please be quiet when you see a sign stating that an AP exam is in progress.
Leadership opportunity. Attention, all royals. There is a 5-day leadership opportunity. Leadership Summit 2019 Human Rights Application in Global Diplomacy taking place this summer in SLO from June 17th to June 21st. Leadership Summit attendees earn up to 20 community service hours and spaces limited to 20 people. If you are interested, please see either Ms. K or Ms. Ham for more details.
Seniors, Naviance. Seniors, please update your Naviance family connection with the college you are planning on attending.
Please do it so we don't have to say it anymore.
Battle of the Bands is next Monday, May 20th at 6:30 p.m. This is a fundraiser for Jack's Helping Hand, an organization that assists children in SLO County who have special needs and cancer. This is a very special charity to Mission Prep because Jack Reddy, Jack Helping Hand's namesake, would have been a senior at Mission Prep this year.
Spirit points and Battle of the Bands. Each class gets points for the percent of students that attend and how many guests they bring that are friends and family. Each class gets points for spirit and sportsmanship. Humble winners and gracious losers will be awarded.
Lockers. Before the school year is over, you must completely empty and clean your locker and return your combination lock to Mr. Lugo, room 311. Remember, there is a replacement fee if you have lost your lock.
Yo, why you open your eyes so big when you talk?
Oh. Royal Day, Tuesday, May 21st. At the beginning of the day, students are to report to their C-period classes at 8:30 a.m. Yes, you get to sleep in for a little. Dress code is formal dress. The Royal Day Success Ceremony is from 9 to approximately 11 a.m. Yearbooks will be distributed to the gym after the Royal Day Success Ceremony.
YouTuber. After the Royal Day Success Ceremony, students and faculty will be permitted to change their clothes into picnic attire. All clothing must be school appropriate. Please be modest. Between the end of Royal Day Success Ceremony and 2 p.m., we will be having a school-wide celebration picnic and free tri-tip barbecue. There will also be games in the cafe and on the field. We are looking forward to this end of the year celebration.
Hey, Cooper, what's today?
Later.
Mission.
Welcome to Behind the Music,
This is a 7-part series on the legendary MCP faculty band, The Keepers. Among all the musicians of the late 20th and early 21st century, few are as obscure and little known as Tom O'Brien. Born in 1958 in the small Ohio town of Xenia, Tom grew up in the era of the Beatles and the Monkees. From a very early age, Tom felt that he was destined to join the ranks of the greatest guitar players of the century. Honing his skills, Tom practiced endlessly for hours and hours. In kindergarten, to become a virtuoso in music, conducting the kindergarten class in a rendition of the Itsy Bitsy Spider. That appearance alone catapulted Tom into the music scene. And then, at age 14, Tom and his friend Chris Mayhew introduced the world to ballads and tight harmonies. But their hopes were dashed when their style and music were stolen by the lesser-known group of Simon and Garfunkel. That threw O'Brien into a tailspin of depression. His music career halted, his voice gone, leading Don McLean to write in his well-known musical ballad, Bye Bye Miss American Pie, that this was the day that music died. But moving to Europe, Tom found his voice again, this time in church music. Tom joined his sister Mary in singing worship music with the tight harmonies Tom was once known for. Their style of singing would later inspire such brother-sister groups as the Carpenters. Eventually joining another band, the Folk Three, Tom was quick to learn the drums before switching to become the bass player for the group. Years passed, and Tom moved from Europe to California, becoming a singer-songwriter in the Santa Cruz Mountains. Ordained as a deacon in the Catholic Church in 2012, Tom O'Brien continues his music career as a church musician. He's never forgotten his roots as a young guitarist in the small town of Xenia, Ohio. And that's the story of Deacon Tom O'Brien, behind the music.